Wants Hawaii here for another edition of Today's Windsor. Well, we're here at Lifestyle Peak Performance Training Center, and let me tell you, taking a nice little leisurely stroll on this great little treadmill. What's really cool is it's an extension of Lifestyle Family Fitness. They've got tons of stuff. Like if you look to my left, something like this was actually seen in American Gladiator. And it's got a lot of things and a lot of trainers that come here and help you. And I'll tell you a little bit more. But also, this little machine over here is like a vibrating machine. And it kind of vibrates or something. Again, I'll tell you a little bit more about it. Beside it is a stationary bike. And, obviously it's a bike. And, it moves. And so do I. Why does this keep moving? Amy!
Actually really good
lead.
That was
funny. Amy, I thought we were friends.
How?
I'm not. I'm okay. Dave, trainer, Amy, pain in the ass. I like her so much. She's gonna go through this with me. Dave Wharton's here at Lifestyle Family Fitness, and you realize how out of shape you are when you start getting on something like a treadmill and you can't keep up.
Absolutely. It doesn't help when you have somebody sneaking up on you, though.
There you go. Didn't help. But you know what? This is something that's really good that I think we need to discuss, because I know we've got Lifestyle Family Fitness right beside here, but this is an extension of it. And for those who don't know what the extension is all about, maybe tell me a little bit about what this facility is all about.
This facility was designed with athletes in mind, but what we've done now is we've taken that original concept and said, well, if it's beneficial for athletes to have a private training center, why not train our clients here? And actually what's happened now is the majority of our high-level, very exclusive personal training clients all train in here. Once people are in here, they prefer it for a lot of reasons. We can do more types of training, higher variety. Like we talked about, it's exclusive and it's private, so some of the things like Amy alluded to earlier, how you might not be so inclined to try an exercise if you're not comfortable doing it in here, you don't have anybody watching you other than your trainer, and maybe another client or two. So it just brings that exclusivity to people who are looking for that, and it gives us the availability to do exercises and types of training that we can't do over there that just gets you benefits even faster.
Oh, absolutely. And by doing so too, like you said, you talked about that comfort level. If I am a heavier set person or someone who is a little bit more shy, this gives us that little one-on-one so I don't feel so intimidated by, buff people.
Absolutely. The concept of coming into a gym can be intimidating for anybody, let alone somebody who has already developed that insecurity as a result of whatever it may be, inability, weight, personal image, based on a lot of things. At Lifestyle, we do a great job of creating an environment that anybody can be comfortable in, but regardless of how hard we work to do that, it can still be intimidating for people. What this gives people is that option to get into fitness, establish a basic level of fitness and comfort with how healthy they are. Then we can take the private training we do here, train them next door, integrate them into the environment, teach them how to use the machines, kind of make them aware of what's going on so they are more comfortable, and eventually set them off on their own. So with initial investment, they get what they need, and then they're on their own in the gym.
And the last thing you want is people to find fear as a hindrance.
Absolutely.
I mean, you don't want that to end up being your focus, because then you won't get what you want.
Exactly. And okay. Most people get into fitness for that reason. They don't like how they look. Their doctor told them they need to change something. It's based on something that is negative. The last thing you want to do is walk into an environment that perpetuates that negativity, because then you'll just quit.
Absolutely.
And then you never get healthier, you're never happier, and that's the opposite of what we want to achieve at Lifestyle.
What's great too is there's, you've talked about the one-on-one training. There's more than one trainer that is available to help someone, correct?
Absolutely. I've got a team of trainers here.
And in doing so, male, female, young, old, does it matter?
Not at all. My personal client profile ranges from 12-year-old female to 53-year-old male, and I've had everything higher and lower than that, and in between, whether it's weight loss, sports conditioning, and I've got trainers here like Tyler. You just have to let us know what you need, and we'll tell you how to achieve it.
Let's talk realistically about the difference between going to a gym on my own, whether it's with a good girlfriend, or doing this by myself, as opposed to having a trainer take you through. Where are the benefits from having that trainer?
There's a couple of them. The one that most people are concerned about is how fast can I get my results? Right now, having said that, one of the problems with how fast can I get my results is what am I willing to sacrifice? And most people are willing to sacrifice safety and common sense in order to achieve their goals as quickly as they can. And that's a problem for us. Us as trainers, we can make that program as efficient and as safe as we can, so you'll get your results quick and you'll do it safely, which means you'll be able to maintain them long term. If you do it on your own, you're guessing what to do, You're worse, you're probably following a program one of your friends gave you that isn't designed for you. You're following a magazine, which means nobody's showing you how to do it, or you're buying into one of these systems, whether it be CrossFit or P90, and you're not having any instruction, but it's giving you a green light to do all kinds of very advanced exercises that is just going to get you injured.
Yeah, and speaking of that, something like P90X, I see that, my friends are doing it, I want to take it. A good point that you made, and I think, you know, our viewers need to know this too, I take P90X and it might have worked for, we'll just use Amy as the example. Let's say she did it, it worked for Amy. I go and take it, and Amy's been working out for a while, so she's familiar with some of the things that she needs to do and not to do. Can I theoretically do damage to myself if I'm doing P90X or any of those if I don't know the right technique, the right movements, things like that?
No question. The way I used to explain it to people when they start bringing up CrossFit and any of these other exercise packages, because unfortunately in the fitness industry, that's what I have to contend with now, because everybody's making promises at 2 o'clock in the morning for results based on short-term and unrealistic things. But just like anything else, could you imagine if nobody ever taught you how to drive a car and just gave you a set of keys?
True.
Can you imagine what would have happened?
Oh, absolutely.
You would have killed yourself,
absolutely.
Killed someone.
Absolutely.
Wildly
very dangerous.
Fitness is no different. If you look around, there's a lot of very heavy objects in here, awkward things to do, a lot of machines next door that can be really complicated. If you're not shown how to use them properly, it's just like taking a drive in a car without any instruction. You're going to hurt yourself. It may not happen right away, but it's going to happen sooner or later. And whether or not you open up that can of worms early, sooner or later it's going to get open. By having somebody guide you through it, it makes sure that you learn how to drive that car properly, make sure you learn how to use this equipment properly, you're never gonna get hurt.
And lastly, before we get into our next segment, let's talk briefly. You've got everything you could imagine in this place, right? And some of the things that you might not necessarily see at Lifestyles.
Yeah.
And that's because of the exclusive training that you're doing or specific types of training that you're doing?
Both. Types of training and exclusivity. We've got a lot of open space here, which means we can use a lot of stuff like kettlebells, use a lot of the buzzwords people are saying in fitness right now. We got kettlebells, medicine balls, functional training stations. We've got our TRX suspension training, body weight. We do plyometric athletic stuff, dumbbells. We've got synthetic ice surface. We've got turf to do agility training on, a track. We've got tires to flip over. Everything you can think of, we've got it here.
I like it. Except you don't have me here yet, but you're going to.
We will.
Because you're going to put me into shape, right?
We'll just change the shape.
Change the shape. Okay, I like that. And Amy, are you up for the challenge? Because you
I'm
and
up
I.
For the challenge.
Let's just, because I want to see. Mm-hmm. You know, let's try out some of the equipment. They've talked about a lot of the equipment. We'll go through it and see how well we do.
Yeah. Absolutely.
Who do you think is going to win?
I saw you on the treadmill there. You looked pretty. No, you were good.
Oh, okay. I thought she was kidding. No. Okay, so when we come back, I'm going to kick her butt, or she's going to kick mine, or I'm going to be on my butt. One or the other.